Hi, in this video, we'll see how to get started using the MultiWorld plugin to add multiple independent worlds to your projects in Unreal Engine. The plugin is available on the Unreal Engine Marketplace. See the link in the video description. For this tutorial, we'll start with an empty project. First, we'll open the plugins menu and ensure that the MultiWorld plugin is enabled. Next, we'll need to change some of the project settings to work with MultiWorld. In the Maps and Mode section, we'll set the Game Instance class to MultiWorld Game Instance. And in the General Settings section, we'll set the default Game Viewport Client class to MultiWorld Game Viewport Client. These classes are provided with the plugin and are required in order to intercept some important system calls. More information on this and how it can be implemented with your own custom overrides can be found in the documentation. Now let's see how we can use the MultiWorld plugin to switch between two completely distinct types of games. For the first game, we'll use the standard third-person template, and for the second game, we'll use the first-person template. We'll use the third-person map as the main world. The main world is a level loaded and managed by Unreal Engine, while secondary worlds are levels managed by the MultiWorld plugin. Only the main world is network replicated. Let's start by loading the secondary world from our main world. To load a secondary world, we'll simply call the loadWorld method. In this example, we'll call it from the begin play event of the level blueprint. And for the map asset, we'll choose the first person map. We'll also store the returned world handle for use later. Note, the returned world handle will only be valid when the completed execution pin is called. Now we'll create a simple teleporting base using a cube and a box trigger. We'll use this to move the player to the secondary world. When the player overlaps with the trigger box, we'll teleport them to the other world. To do this, we'll simply call the method switchWorld, passing in the handle of the destination world. In this case, we'll call it from the onActiveBeginOverlap event and pass in the handle we stored for the first-person map. And that's all there is to it for the basic use of the plugin. It's really that simple. Now let's do the same in the first-person map to allow the player to return to the main world. The plugin provides a special method, getMainWorldHandle, to get to the handle of the current main world. While we have this level open, we'll also change the lighting setup to make it a bit more interesting. Now we can test our project, starting from the main world. Done. In a few clicks, you can have multiple independent worlds in your game. You can load as many secondary worlds as you like, and you can also transfer actors between different worlds. See the documentation, linked in the video description for all the details. In addition, the plugin can also be used in multiplayer games. The only limitation is that the secondary worlds are not network replicated. All we need is a simple change. We must ensure to call the method switchWorld only on the local client of the player we want to teleport. We can use the standard method isLocallyControlled for this. As you can see, each player has their own unique and persistent version of the secondary world, while the main world is shared and replicated. With the MultiWorld plugin, you can now quickly and easily set up multiple independent worlds in your Unreal projects. That's all for this tutorial. Thanks for watching, and remember that you can find more information about the MultiWorld plugin in the Unreal Engine Marketplace. See the link in the video description.